Good morning, students. Myself Deepali Harchande. Today we are going to see the new lesson, lesson number 1.3, the cop and the anthem. The story had been written by William Sidney Porter. His pen name was O. Henry. His original name is William Sidney Porter. He had born on September 11, 1862 at Greensboro, North Carolina, US. And he passed away on June 5, 1910 in New York. He was known as American short story writer, whose tales romanticized the commonplace, in particular the life of ordinary people in New York City. His stories expressed the effect of coincidence on character through humor, grim or ironic, and often had surprise endings, a device that became identified with his name and cost him critical favor when it's vogue. Vogue means style or fashion, and style and fashion had passed. The story, The Cop and the Anthem, is one of O. Henry's well-known stories. To describe his style of writing, people have often used the term smile with tears, which implies his twisted way of thoughts and endings in almost every story. We'll see something or a few things about story. In his story, the main character is Soapy. He is a vagabond and a person with criminal background. He makes different plans to re-enter the prison as he has no shelter to protect himself from the severe winter. The story ends in an unexpected way. O. Henry has depicted Soapy's futile attempts to arrest it in a very humorous vein. If we see in a simple way of story, Soapy wanted to get arrested from the cops. Cops means policeman. And he wanted to rescue himself. He wanted to protect himself from the winter of the city. And for arresting himself, he is taking lots of efforts, but his all efforts are in vain. He could not convince even the cops for what offense the cops would arrest him. So let's see the story. Before going through the story, I have already given here a web chart that you have to solve it, ways to protect from cold climate. To solve this web chart, you have to go through the textbook, read the lesson, and then solve this answer. Now we'll start with the actual story. The story name is Cop and the Anthem. As I told you that cop means the policeman. In our country, we are calling it policeman, but in America, they have been called as a sergeant or the cop. Now we'll see page-wise summary. Let's see the background of the lesson. Ever heard the saying, "Be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it"? The main character of this story is the epitome of that saying, we all think we want or need something. We sometimes even get desperate of it. Sometimes, though, it's exactly what we never wanted. In The Cop and the Anthem, Soapy thinks the best thing for him is to be arrested. Does he ever get what he wants? Is it really what he wants? Now we'll see in this lesson. Now first page, I'm giving you a brief summary of it. It's the beginning of fall in New York. Soapy is on a bench at home, which is Madison Square. Madison Square, it's a name of that place where Soapy was living, he was staying. He is a homeless man who is in despair at the thought of winter coming. He will no longer be able to keep warm under newspapers. He starts to think of alternatives. As we have seen, though Soapy was without home, he was a homeless person, so he didn't have anything to protect himself from the cold of the America. As we know, in America, the winter was extremely cold, and there we cannot survive without any blankets, coats, or any other material. So in that time, he wanted to protect himself from that cold, and in the prison, at least he will get shelter. For that shelter, he tried to get himself arrested by the cops. Now he starts thinking alternative, how he could arrest himself by the sergeants, and he started doing various efforts. As we have seen, he has started thinking about the alternatives. The first alternative was, he know that a shelter in the city will board him, but they ask so many questions. He sets his mind on going to Blackwell Island, or the island as he refers to it. The island in an easy enough place to get to. All he has to do is get himself arrested. Shelter, food, rules, warmth, and no questions. Once he got arrested, so he could solve his problem of shelter, food, and warmth. Soapy sets out to make his way to the island. He knows of a fancy restaurant on Broadway, there enlists eat. He will go there, order dinner, and inform them that he has no means to pay for it. They will have him arrested, and the judge will give him 3 months for certain. It seems simple enough, so he goes ahead to the restaurant. He is already decided what to order. It is his plan. As we have seen, the very first plan, he wanted to go in a fancy restaurant. As we know that he was homeless, he didn't have money, and that's why this is one plan to get him arrested. So what he is going to do, after taking dinner or after having dinner, he will tell the waiter or the owner of that restaurant that he had no money to pay them. So that time the hotel manager will be informed to the inspector, will be informed to the cop, and he would get arrested in this way. So that was the first plan of the Soapy, and he was very eagerly, or he was very eager to achieve or to implement that plan and to achieve his goal. What was his goal? To get arrested by the cop and be warmth, or to protect himself from the coldness of the American island, or in the American island. It seems simple enough. So he goes ahead to the restaurant. He has already decided what to order in that restaurant. He won't rake up too high of a bill, just enough to feel himself and get arrested. But what happened next? Unfortunately, the head waiter spots him as he walks in with his torn clothes and messed up shoes. He is immediately escorted out. Escorted out means he immediately, here escorted means to force someone to leave the place. Here, the head waiter forced Soapy to leave the restaurant. He didn't give him permission to enter this restaurant. So the plan was totally failed. Now he thought about the plan B. Now let's see what was the plan B. Let's see the next plan of Soapy to get arrested himself. While walking on 6th Avenue, he breaks a glass window with a stone, making sure a cop was close enough to be the first on the scene. The cop asks Soapy where the culprit was. Here, purposefully, Soapy break the glass of one shop, and he was knowing that the cop was nearby him, and absolutely it has happened that cop asked Soapy what had happened and who had broke that glass. And the cop was asking who was the culprit in that matter. Amazed, Soapy asked why the cop doesn't think it was him. Means he was thinking that ki why cop could not understand the Soapy one of him who had done this offense. He realizes that, he means the Soapy, he realizes that the wrongdoers don't just stand and wait for the cops after committing a crime. The cop chases someone else and Soapy walks away. Again, he failed in his plan. Soapy stood aside and the cops or the policemen, they had chased someone else. Hence, his plan was totally failed. Now, again he started thinking about the third plan. Let's see what was the third plan. His next plan is to dine and not dash in a not so unscale joint. He eats, he tells them he has no money, and instead of calling the cops, two waiters pick him up and physically toss him out in the back alley. Now Soapy is feeling like his plan to spend winter in prison is a dream. Means here again he had acted like the last previous restaurant. He had some food and he told that waiters that he had no money to give him. So instead of calling the cops, the waiters, they toss him out in the back alley. Toss him out means they thrown him in the back alley. Again his plan was totally failed. So he was feeling very sad He was feeling that now to become arrested is a dream for him. Now he was in anxiety that he has to spend the winter in the street only, as he was homeless, so he was worried about it. Again he thought something and he started implementing the next plan. Now let's see what he did in the next, his third plan. He spots a refined looking woman standing in earshot of a cop. He walks up to her and solicits her, hoping she will scream for help. Instead, she responds positively and says he should buy her a drink. She says that she hadn't approached him first since the cop was nearby. He runs as fast as he can where he gets the chance. Solicit means to request someone. So he tried to request the woman who was standing beside that cop, and he was expecting that at least that woman will scream for the help to this cop, and again the cop will arrest him. That was the plan of the Soapy. But instead of calling cop, the woman asked Soapy to buy drink for her. She says that she hadn't approached him first since the cop was nearby. And after that, the Soapy runs fast he can when he gets the chance. After that, he come up with the new plan. That was, he spots some cops near the theaters. He starts to rant loudly, pretending to be drunk. He gets mistaken for a college boy and is ignored. In spite of pretending to be a drunk person, the cop, they didn't arrest him. They were thinking that the person who was drunk here, who was a college boy, and just they ignored him. And hence again the Soapy's plan was destructed. Now he became very panicked. He became very hopeless and he could not think what to do next. Now he started thinking about what to do next. Now let's see what he had done or what was his plan to arrest himself. Now he tried for the next plan. Let's see the plan. Soapy tries to bluntly steal an umbrella from a man in a store. When the man questioned Soapy, he tells the man to call the cops because he is taking the umbrella. And he was requesting that man to call cops to arrest him. The man backs down, saying he had found it earlier and didn't realize that Soapy was its true owner. Means here the man also got the umbrella somewhere in the street, and he was not knowing who was the owner of that umbrella. So that time he was thinking that Soapy was the true owner of that umbrella, and that person, that man, was requesting Soapy to take back his umbrella. Henceforth again his plan was destroyed because that man had not called police, had not called cop. Now Soapy loses all these hopes. He was feeling like he is invincible and can do no wrong. Means he was not wrong. he was the correct person. He had not done any wrong things, so he assumed that things. He started thinking about his past life. One time he does not want that to happen. He walks down a quieter street and hears an anthem. The wonderful sound takes him down memory lane back to his younger days with his family. Means he was thinking about his past when he was living with his family members. He was returning from the church. He stops to listen some more music. The music fills his heart. There is a sudden comprehension of his failures and his lack of abilities. He sees how he has let himself down and how he can get himself out of his rut. He remembers someone who offered him a job, so he is going to find that man. He is going to get himself back on his feet again. As this happens, a cop puts his hand on Soapy's shoulder and asks him what he is doing there so late at night. When he says nothing, the cop doesn't believe him and argues his point. The story ends with a judge saying, 3 months on the island, and finally, when he was not expecting to arrest himself after listening the music, but he had got arrested by the cop after doing nothing. He was just sitting and he was just listening the music, but the cop was not ready to believe him, to believe on him, and he had imprisoned him. And judge has given that judgment that something has been done by the Soapy. How does we come to know the Soapy has got imprisoned by the cop? See, this is the last line. From this line we come to know. The last line is, 3 months on the island, said the magistrate in the police court the next morning. In this way, we come to know, or we have learned about the story, the cop and the anthem. If we see the summary, then we have to think about the character of Soapy. Then we have to think about his plans. Then the 3 to 4 plans he had done, and how he could not implement these plans, means to get inside in the restaurant, then not to pay the bill. Then after that he stolen the umbrella of a person, but again he could not get success in that also. Then lastly, he approached the woman, but that woman also, in spite of or instead of calling cops, he requested him to get drink for her. So these all the all failure plans had been done by the Soapy. But last, when he was walking on the street, so that time he heard a music, and that music was an anthem music. From that music, he realized that what is the life, then how life is worthy. That time he was thinking that it was a great thing that he could not be arrested by the cops. That time he was feeling very happy, because whatever his family background and the culture of family, he was feeling very happy. He was feeling very rescued that cop has not been arrested him. when he was thinking that thing, when he was thinking about the life, at the same time, a cop approached him and he was asking him, why you are sitting here? So that time he said, no, I'm not doing anything. Or the cop was asking him, what you are doing here? So he said that just I'm sitting here. So that time policeman doubt him and he was asking him, you must have done something and that is why you are sitting here. So finally, when he want not to arrested by the cops, but he got arrested by the cops and he felt very sad. He felt very discouraged or very, he felt very despondency or dissolution. He felt very regretted for all his evil deeds. So in this way, students, we have completed with the 1.3, the cop and the anthem. I hope after listening this story, you could solve the web chat, ways to protect from cold climate. Here you need to write few plans or four plans which has been arranged, which has been set by the SOPI to protect himself from cold, to protect himself from the cold climate. If you have any doubt, write your doubts in the comment box. I try to solve your queries. Thank you.